This is Ben from the Be a Photographer channel, and in this video we're going to take a look at how I like to edit eyes in my portraits using Capture One Pro 20. Now this method can be done in Photoshop, Affinity Photo, Lightroom, whatever editor you're using, and I'm going to show you how to take it from this image all the way through here, and most importantly we're going to focus on the eyes. So you can see that if I turn off these adjustments here, we get just a little bit more pop in the eyes, and I'm going to walk you through this portion, but quickly, we're going to begin with just the base image, and I'll tell you what I did to make it pop at first. Firstly, what I did was I changed the white balance on the image. So if we reset the white balance here, you can see that we were a little bit more in the blues and purples. So I reset the white balance. Then I adjusted my exposure because the original image was pretty dark like this. And once I did that, you can see that it blew out a lot of the image. So what I did is some highlight recovery using the high dynamic range tab. So once it was too bright, I pulled down the highlights and pulled down the blacks, and I also adjusted my levels to change the contrast. Now I have videos on all of these different tools already on the channel, so if you want, check them out. I'll leave a link in the description to the Capture One Pro Editing Basics playlist. And so once I got the image from here to about here in terms of color and exposure, I went ahead and I used the heel brush in order to remove some of the spots like the indent from his glasses and also this highlight that's coming in through some of the tree branch that's above Nick in this shot. So you can see I removed that using heel layers, and then I went in and started editing the eyes. So you can see the eyes look pretty good in this image already, and then when I added my adjustments, you can see that they just got a little bit brighter and got a little bit more detail in the actual colored portion of the iris. So how do we do this? Well, let's delete these two layers and I'll walk you through it. Using layer masks, first we're going to zoom into the image, create a new empty adjustment layer, and I'm going to call this one eye whites. So once I have that layer created, I'm going to hit B for brush. I'm going to select my brush size by right clicking and dragging to the left and hit M on my keyboard so I can see the mask. So I'm just going to create two triangles here. And this is for just the whites of the eyes. The reason I just create those triangles with a gap in the middle is I then right click and hit fill mask, and it now fills those areas. I move over to the other eye, and I'm going to do the same thing here. And now when I zoom out, you can see that we have the whites of both eyes selected. If I tap M on my keyboard, we can disable viewing the mask with a red overlay, and now we can control just those parts of the eyes. So you can see if I brought the exposure all the way down, that is the part that it's controlling. So I'm not going to change the exposure. All I'm going to do is change the saturation and bring it down so that it makes the whites of the eyes whiter. You can see if it was oversaturated, it would make the eyes really yellow, and we're just going to essentially make them white. Now, if you went to minus 100, you'll see that it turns the eye kind of blue and it doesn't fit the rest of the image very well. So what I recommend is zooming out and just playing with your saturation slider until it's about there where the whites of the eyes now look white. And you can see that that clears up the image just a tiny bit. So I'll probably go right about here. And you can already see there's a little bit of a difference. And now what we can do is adjust the exposure just a tiny, tiny bit. So you can see now we have the eye whites and they're a little bit brighter. Okay, so the eye whites look good. It's going to make the eyes pop a little bit. What are we going to do next? The next step is to create another layer. So we're going to hold down new empty adjustment layer, and we will call this eye color, iris, whatever you want. For this, you can either use a brush or the circular mask tool, but I'm just going to use a brush here, and I'm going to simply mask over the center of the eye. It doesn't have to be perfect. It could be, you know, a little bit spill over onto the top and bottom of the eyelids. And now we can control the clarity of the eye to add a little bit more detail. Also the brightness. And I'm going to boost the highlights a little bit as well. So now you can see the eyes pop a ton in terms of that eye color in the middle. And they look like they're glowing a little bit too much, right? Especially this one on the side here. So all I have to do is lower my opacity of that layer. I can bring the eye whites layer down as well. And now you can see the difference is very subtle, but it's there with the eye whites and also with the eye color. And that is the big goal of editing. When you edit, you don't want it to make it seem like, wow, this is really heavily edited. This is altered a lot in post-processing. You want it to look natural. And I believe that is what we were able to achieve here by using some color techniques, by just changing the white balance and the levels, and then adjusting the eyes by, again, creating those eye whites to be desaturated. and also enhancing the center of the eye so we see a little bit more color and pop in the highlights. Hopefully this tutorial helped you out. If you learned something, I hope you subscribe. If you have a tutorial request, please leave a comment down below, and I'll see you in the next video. Thanks for watching. Peace.